Hey guys, Summit Man here with another Let's Play episode. We are going to start off with showing you some of the new stuff that I've done. I have made two igneous extruders that, do nothing but make cobblestone for my recyclers. I have two recyclers. I also made an extractor and a compressor. I have three generators feeding my MFE, or MFSU, and I have UU Matter, or a mass fabricator to make UU Matter. The reason I have that is because I want a quantum suit. With the pants make you run really fast, and if you hold control and spacebar, the boots make you jump really far. Like so. Now, I will also show you something else. I spent a little bit of time, well, not a little bit, but a lot of bit of time, AFKing down at one of my zombie spawners. I found a second one. As you can see, zombie dungeon, I have marked the second one. And a spider one. I didn't even start on spiders yet, but what we're going to do today is I'm going to build a spawning area for the zombies. Now, light level does not matter, but the problem with that is if you have it in the daylight, they're going to die without you being able to kill them. And I want to be able to make... Now, this is how you make a soul cage. The iron bars, which is six iron ingots, three there and there. But I want to be able to kill them myself for experience, because as you see, I'm low on experience. I only have one level. And that's because it is. It's a maze map, or maze... thingy or Bob, I can't remember the exact name of it. Let me just type it in here. Maze. What was it? Maze map focus. I found that in the Twilight, which is added by the Twilight Forest, and you can put anything in here to make, you know, in this uncrafting table. Now this also repairs items and so on, but it costs experience. And I, killing the zombies, this is just some of what's left. Well, this wasn't part of it, but there was a bunch of stuff. Now, I want to see how that chain, the chain plates and stuff come apart, because the only way to get them is cheat them in, or cheat fire into your inventory. So, I would like to see how that, you know, turns out. Maybe I can get fire, maybe I can't. Maybe they won't let me take them apart. Maybe they'll let me repair them. I don't know. But I have a slight problem with my zombies, or my villagers. They keep despawning. I don't know why I'm just doing one level, but I'm going to fix that now. But my villagers keep despawning. So I'm going to have to look into a better way of taking care of the villagers, getting them to stay around. Because like I said, I want to get into Mistcraft a little more. But until I get some of the map pieces, or pages, or whatever you want to call them, I can't really do much. So today what we're going to do is we're going to set up this zombie spawner. And of course this is going to be one of my only buildings with a roof. I will not light it up. In the beginning I will to build it and stuff. But we're going to build a small killing area. That way we can just sit there as they spawn. Now I think they can spawn up to 6 at a time, and they spawn every 2 seconds. So with something like that, that's going to be a great addition to, I mean, hey, you get a bunch of stuff, you get a bunch of experience. I mean, God only knows what you get from. When I was down there, I got a bunch of soul shards, which, shards of minium, which are used for the minium stone, which that in turn will help you convert stuff into, you can convert dirt, almost anything into diamonds in a roundabout way. But you need the shards of minium to keep going and stuff. And that's something that I got over a stack killing the zombies. I ended up finding 2 spawners, like I said. But like I said, you know, it's 1,024 kills. So you can guarantee I was down there for a while. You get 200 souls per shard. So I only got 400 for free, basically. The rest I killed myself, which, let me tell you, that wasn't fun, because you just had to sit there, and it was boring, but I also have some stuff I want to show you in the Twilight Forest, which, we're probably not going to get to this episode, but in the Twilight Forest, I found a. Oh, I'm going to have to go sleep, darn it. I found a Hollow Hill and one of those Meef dungeons or whatever you want to call them. And I did mark them on the. W put waypoints on the map so we can mark them. When my full quantum suit is done, which may be a while, I just have the pants and boots right now. But when my full quantum suit is done, we will be going there. I don't feel like dying a lot there, so that's why I'm getting a full quantum suit. I did have a full nano suit. Ooh, I'm gonna need more of them, but let's go sleep. I did have a full nano suit, but that, that's not perfect. That doesn't give you all these extra features and stuff. So, we're gonna get ourselves a good full suit. Yeah. Quantum suit and stuff. Oh, I only have 60 of these. Do I have any more marble around? Marble, marble. But I also built a sawmill, which turns one log instead of getting four when you put it in your inventory and turn it. Gives you six. Now, of course, it uses power and stuff, but hey, that way I don't have to go searching for so much. Oh, there we go. That way I don't have to go searching for so much wood, even though I'm not really searching for it right now. I'm hurting for copper. And you can't use the minium stone to get copper, so I don't know what I'm gonna do at the moment. Looks like I'm gonna be without copper. I mean, with the scrap boxes, you have a chance. Out of 40 scrap boxes, I got one copper dust. So I'm gonna need a lot of copper before I can finish my quantum suit because that takes a lot of electronic circuits and stuff. That's why I built the extractor, so I didn't have to look for so much rubber. But I'm hoping that as this progresses and stuff, I'll find more copper. They say you can change the config files, get it to spawn at more levels, but does that really even help? Does it spawn more? Or is it still the same amount, just spawning at more levels? I did find more diamonds. I did make some diamonds too, which cost me two minium stones to make, I think, 10 or 12 diamonds or whatever. Actually, no more than that because I made diamonds and used them to repair my sword. Excuse me. But, like I said, the goal of today is to be. Is to set up a full. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. I hate when that does that. Is to set up a full, zombie spawner. And killing area. I'm not even. I have a tier 2 pig shard now, but I'm not really 100% worried about making all that yet. I hope I brought my torches. Yeah. But I'm not really worried about the pig and cow yet because I do have a lot of pig, a lot of meat and apples, and I can always farm for more if I need to. But my biggest concern right now is stuff that I need, like with the zombies and all. I can get the now I can get the minium shard. I'm not gonna try and kill Blazes. That's just insane. But I think the easiest. Where the heck did I put that soul cage? Oh, you gotta be kidding me. But I think the easiest thing is killing zombies. Spiders aren't that bad, but they have to set it up a little differently, and they can climb the wall and hide from you and all that. But I like zombies. Skeletons, they have that range. Creepers, they keep exploding. Can you tell? I was out here hunting zombies one night, and I'm like, no, I'm going down. I only want zombies. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Darn it. Let's take this down. Because I want to put 1, 2. I'm gonna put. This is gonna be glass where I'm standing, but or from the marble up. Sorry about this. I'm losing my voice and getting sick, and just can't kick whatever I have. But this will all be glass. So how many do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So. Let's try it this way. 1, 2, 3, 4. That looks about center. Yeah, we'll go with that. Now, before I do that, I want to put redstone. Let me see how that blaze spawner is set up, because I know I had problems with that in the beginning, too. Running fast works to an extent. Gets you there a little faster, but get lost at the same time. Do I have the redstone red? Yeah, the redstone's running right into it, so I should be okay. Oh, man, sorry. Sorry about this, guys. But, and you can't run real fast unless you, you know, just like you can't sprint and you don't have full hunger. Or above 3. Same way with the quantum boots. Now, I think if you have the full suit, it might act differently, but this is actually the first time I'm building the quantum suit. Let me finish redstone here. I mean, it's not like the zombies can break it, so let me break that one. And right there, where's my lever? There's my lever. That way, they don't spawn until I'm done. But, you know, I could have gone with less and just not controlled it, but I'd prefer to... darn it, I forgot to put that down. I prefer to control it. That way they're not spawning and causing lag. I'm already having some lag. It's not real bad, but my frame rate's a little lower than I'd like it to be. Right now I'm pushing about 90 frames per second, which isn't too bad, but get a lot of machines going, it gets... the lag gets a little crazy. Now that should be okay. I think I'm going to hook up some lighting in here so nothing else spawns. Well, actually, I don't think I have to worry about that. Because I could have probably put the light level up. And you know what? I'm going to try that. What's worse, it happens. We have to turn the spawner off and knock the torches out. I'm not going to put a lot in, just 3. And see how that works. That might work better. Now let's finish this glass off. Oh, you know what? Wonder if I should. Yeah, I'm gonna do this. And bring the floor up. That way we're not face to face. I'm like kinda killing their feet. Let's see how this works. And normally when I do this stuff off camera, I thought I'd, you know, since I'm doing a lot of building off camera, I'd do a little more on camera. See if you guys like that. I'm also gonna maybe down the road do a water piston thing where the water will push the, I get just flip a lever, water will push the zombies to drop zone. Is it getting dark outside or is it just me? Push them to a drop zone, and they'll drop, you know, they'll go up a mob elevator using signs and water, and then drop them off, you know, like 30 blocks. That way, you know, we can just sit there and collect their loot if we wanted. You know, I might do something like that. Now let me remove this one here. Should be able to sit here, put the glass in. Should be able to sit there. Kind of like I set up my spawner, you know, when I find a zombie spawner naturally. Ooh, goody. And they come to me. And this is all we'll do. Like, see that those shards? That's what this is basically going to be, a shard spawner. Hold on, let me turn the volume down. That's basically what this is going to be, a shard spawner and experience spawner. And down the road I might use turtles to kill them. Then it's not going to be hard to set that up. But use brain into jars. I'm going to have to get working on that. What is it? Bombcraft? Okay, there's just way too many zombies here. But that's basically how we're going to do it. That'll be our killing area. Ooh. I'm going to put doors on this one and the other one. Let me see. Let's see if I can get their attention. That'll work. I guess they don't see through glass. Yeah, I might have to use... I might have to use turtles because... This is just gonna be too, you know, killing my swords all the time. But there we go, we have our new zombie spawner. And I'm up to level 15. Exactly what I wanted to show you is... I gotta take the block back out. Come on. But we'll sleep real quick and I'll show you. I should have enough experience to show you how that uncrafting table works. Come on. There we go. But the uncrafting table is real easy to use. You just take whatever you want. Like... Let's do this because I want my gold back. Now that I got off of out of a scrap box. That's why it's not damaged. Yeah, it's not enchanted. See, it needs 5 levels. And you just click here. Go like that. Now, what else do I have? Got that. Let's do the chain. See what that looks like. Ooh. But, it's too damaged. Is this too damaged? Yeah. When they're red like that, you can't take any of that stuff. But let's do this, see if that's anything. Yeah, it'll give us a piece of gold. And as you see, my levels are dropping slowly as I do this stuff. I've got one iron. Oh, see? When it's red like that, you don't have enough levels. But that's how that works. That works out pretty good. Put all this armor back in. Now, I get wooden tools. I don't know if I have any more. Ooh, I should do these. I wonder if that'll give me the diamonds back, I hope. Yep. And it only takes 2 levels. Aha. Now I only have 1 level, but there you go. Now I got diamonds again. More diamonds. More. what's this? That'll give me a thaumium ingot, which I don't know if I need it, but here, I'll show you with this one. Now, I don't know how good this does, but... Okay, see, it won't do a broken one. But when you have wooden tools that you get off the out of the scrap box, or maybe a zombie, I don't know. But if you have something, we'll do a ladder real quick. And maybe a chest. Show you how that sawmill works. But you just take, say, the chest. No, there's 8 there and 7 sawdust. When it's done, it should give us 8. Yep. Oh, it didn't give us a sawdust. Okay. No big deal. Okay, that didn't work. Let me get a log and show you the sawdust. I know where my logs are. Just one. Now, there is a cheat, and I'll show you that. Take this, throw it in here, and it'll give you sawdust. Plus 6. Now I'll show you the cheat. Costs the minium stone, you know, use on the minium stone, but... 1, 2, 3, 4. Do it like that. Now, I got 13 logs. Now this is a way to profit on your sawdust, which is sawdust is only good to make condensed sawdust or whatever, which I have some. And you can then turn that into charcoal. You just put it in a furnace and it turns into charcoal. But right now, I use, as far as charcoal goes, I use the, see, it doubles all our wood. I had just under a stack, I think. But right now I make charcoal out of the what is this? The coke oven. Get creosote. I have a lot of creosote oil. I had a bunch of portable tanks I made. Like you see, there's two there, one there. I think I have one more floating around somewhere. I may or may not. I don't know. But I put the creosote oil into, oh, there it is. The creosote oil into cans. Yep, right there. 64 creosote cans or cells. Now, if you just right-click it on a tank, you're gonna lose that can. But to get it back out, now right now I put lava into these because that's the only thing aluminum's good for. And I'm gonna use the lava down the road for making obsidian and stuff. But I was using netherrack in here, and magma crucible turns it into lava. Then I just put, move the tank over. I just have it go through, and that's the only thing aluminum's good for right now. Water, and now you can make tin cells or tin cans, but aluminum cans, the only thing they're good for is water and lava, I think. Let's check on our power output here. Oh, that's the only problem with running. This is, I did have it fully automated, like the pipe came up here, but when I'd go AFK down below, the scrap would build up because I'd run low on power and it wouldn't use as much in here. But oh yeah, I got some good scrap. Let me turn this on. I have it set to a lever, and as you can see, it's draining power pretty quick, but I'm up to 2 million, so I should get probably 30 or so UU matter out of it. So, but that's how this works. For now, that's basic setup. Once I'm done with my quantum suit, I don't need the UU matter. I mean, I could use the UU matter to make diamonds and stuff, but I should have, yeah, I have 12 diamonds and I just made two more. I put in a chest here at the end. That way, anything that doesn't go into a barrel comes in here. Like that, a bow. I don't know if I can even disassemble that or not. But my next chore is getting myself, well, like you see here, I have two full stacks plus 33 of the minium shards. That's just from doing AFKing with zombies. Now, if I can find my zombie meat right there, 14 stacks of zombie meat from killing all them zombies. That's a lot. I'm slowly going to clean up the inventories here, but for the next episode, I want to work on the bees. I did figure out what I was doing wrong with them. And probably half of you saw this, and hey, I know how to fix that. You gotta look here. Hostile environment. Machine or inhabitants cannot work in this biome. So, I have to move all this, which isn't gonna be hard, but that, I'll do that on camera, show you how to do that. And we're gonna set up an automatic sugarcane farm, since you can't use one of Steve's carts to do that. Steve's carts only works with carrots, potatoes, and wheat, as far as the harvesting goes. But along with the harvesting, now I have flax and corn. Well, what we're gonna do is this all is gonna be disassembled because I'm not gonna need this. I'm gonna set up melon farm, which with the block breaker and stuff, that'll be easier. Corn and flax have two deployers, one on top of another. We're gonna get into a lot of red power stuff. I'm actually going to reduce this area, wrong button. I'm actually going to reduce this area down. I still have some pork chops, I'll just put that right in there. I'm gonna make it a lot smaller. I could have done it in the beginning, but I was just too lazy, I guess. But we what I that's what my next step is, to take up less space. Because this area is really laggy for some reason. I think it's because of everything going on. But we're also gonna, I only have one ender pearl, that aggravates me. But with this minium stone, do I have any iron? But I have iron. Iron. Yep, 4 iron. And that's enough to make an ender pearl. I'm not actually going to make it, but I'll show you how to make it. 2, 3, 4. See? You can make an ender pearl. You can basically turn dirt and cobble into anything, just a roundabout way. And it's less OP, I think, than using the Philosopher's Stone. They still don't have a recipe for that, but Equivalent Exchange 3 is a lot more in tune than Equivalent Exchange 2. You used to be able to collect energy from the sun and all that other stuff, and you could cheat that and just put glowstone on top and go from there, and you used to be able to make diamonds out of thin air. Literally, thin air. And I just don't like that, you know. I did cheat in the beginning. When I was doing Tekkit and stuff, I would cheat. Which, you know, I didn't know that was, you know, I didn't feel that was cheating at first. But then I'm like, yeah, you know, when I have 100 stacks of diamonds, that's a little OP. But we're going to get into different things and maybe clean this area up a little. I do have the enchanting table. When I have extra experience, I hit 30 levels, I'll start enchanting books and stuff. And this is... Oh, that's a card assembler. I did make an anvil while I was out. And, you know, when I was down there because I wanted to repair everything. But that's it for this episode. We now have our new zombie spawner, which is a switch away from, you know, spawning zombies and collecting their loot. And in that little bit of time, I got 5 shards and 39 rotten flesh. Rotten flesh, I think I'm going to use in the recyclers. Because, like I said, if I have, 14 stacks of it? A little too much. And it's not much else good for it. You know, it poisons you every time you eat it, so. But anyway, that's the end of this episode, guys, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you guys want to see anything, if you think, you know, you want to see me do more building and stuff and how things work, just let me know and we'll get to it. Thanks. Bye.